So, welcome to episode 2 of Unengineered. Our first episode was a hit, I guess. I don't know. We got 300 views on Instagram. YouTube is still sucked. So, anyway, we
Subscribe to
got
the
to
YouTube channel.
300.
Subscribe to the YouTube
Yeah,
channel.
subscribe to the
It's
YouTube
very
channel.
good.
There was an exclusive
Adwait
episode
did not
about
put
Apple.
any Instagram links in the description. He did not put
Oh, I
anything.
forgot.
Nothing. There's nothing there, but please go to the YouTube channel.
Yeah, the upload process wasn't necessarily smooth, so
Yeah. First
go.
time.
There is an ex.
First
First
time
time, yeah.
ever.
There is an exclusive episode about Apple on the YouTube channel, so you should go check that out. And welcome to episode 2. We are talking about Starlink. We are talking about what are you talking
We're talking
about?
about Razer Blade laptops that just got launched 2020 with awesome super GPUs
And
and shit like that.
productivity, and then finally we'll
We're
talk
gonna talk
how the
about
order
something
is messed
controversial
up.
that happened regarding the Google
Yeah.
China apps that was initiated by Sonam Wangchuck, who is the inspiration for the Three Idiots movie. So we're gonna talk about that and what happened.
What?
Yeah.
He's the inspiration for the Three Idiots.
Sonam
Oh
Wangchuck.
my god.
What was the name in the movie? Haan.
Oh
From
wow.
Suk Wangdu, Sonam Wangchuk, yeah. Dude, he's literally a scientist in like Tibet.
Oh god, एक सेकंड सो वो उसके वीडियोस वायरल हो रहे हैं यूट्यूब
Yes.
पे टॉकिंग ओह
Yes.
नो वे आई डिड नो दैट
Advait has come to an amazing
सी दिस
realization.
इज आई डिड डू द रिसर्च फॉर दैट पार्ट सो आई डोंट नो
Fair
बट
enough,
आई
fair
डिड
enough.
सी हिज वीडियो आई डिड शेयर हिज वीडियो इट जस्ट नेवर क्लिक्ड
So
दैट
he's literally an
वांगचू
inventor and like a science person. Like it's not exactly, it's not a biography. Three Idiots is not his biography. It's inspired by him and it's dramatized obviously. So that's why he got some
Okay, the college
recognition.
scenes are all fake.
I don't know about that. I don't know that. But he's a scientist and like maybe he didn't run and marry. You know, that's what I'm saying.
अच्छा ओके नहीं आई डोंट केयर अबाउट रनिंग या मैरिज द बिफोर वाला स्टोरी क्या बोलते
हाँ, I don't know, I'm not
हैं
sure.
एज अ किड
I don't know if he made the
ओके
rotor copter, though that is possible.
क्वाड कॉप्टर ओके हाँ
Quadcopter.
एंड
Drone,
ओके सो
as we call it today.
we are again starting with SpaceX for some reason come on man these guys launch rockets faster than we can make these episodes so
Very well
yeah
put.
so हाँ सो व्हेन वी रिलीज द लास्ट एपिसोड तो स्पेसएक्स लॉन्च अनदर फाल्कन 9 रॉकेट एंड इट हैड 60 स्टारलिंग सैटेलाइट्स सो फॉर दोज हु डोंट नो स्टारलिंग इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट एज ऑफ नाउ वेयर दे पुट सैटेलाइट्स ऑल ओवर द अर्थ एंड प्रोवाइड इंटरनेट अ वेरी फास्ट इंटरनेट टू ऑल द प्लेसेस सो
Crazy.
दिस हैज मल्टीपल एप्लीकेशंस या
Absolutely great.
मल्टीपल एप्लीकेशन सो You'll get internet in places where you can't put fiber optic, and you'll get internet that is better than fiber optic. So that is crazy.
Oof.
I mean,
It's right out
so
of
how do you
the
use
sci-fi
that?
movies, I mean.
Yeah, it's. I mean, we are gonna live in the future. See, I've come to a point where I know about tech, and then what's gonna happen future, and I'm
Huh,
like,
you can.
shit, I'm living in the
Huh.
past. Yeah. And you know when your parents tell you that we didn't have these smartphones and yeah, and you feel like shit, how are people
Exactly.
living at that time? I'm here there right now. I
Exactly,
don't know
exactly.
if that makes sense. So these satellites they are closer to Earth than what normal satellites are so there is a bit of a concern because they'll have to launch 42,000 satellites. 42,000 satellites
Oh
covering the
yeah.
entire
Hey, I
Earth.
recently did a presentation on satellites. And if I'm not wrong, then they are the like lower Earth. So the farther the satellites are from the Earth, the more area they can cover, right?
Yeah,
So
so
because they are very near
normally,
to the Earth, huh?
yeah, so normally there is a triangle that they cover, but when then, so some companies have already done this, like space and satellite and provided internet, but they keep the satellites 32,000 kilometers away, so the latency is really high.
Really high.
And
Offering.
so, but the reason they did it is because they wanted to provide internet to a specific region, so the satellites has to be geo-locked with that region, so it has to be
Oh,
that far.
हाँ बराबर समझा सो इट विल मूव विद दैट प्लेस राइट
Yeah, move with that place. So what happened is, if you put the satellites this close, they have to have higher velocities to keep them
राइट
in orbit.
बराबर बराबर
So to cover a certain region, they need so many satellites so that at any
एक्सैक्टली
given point, some satellite will be there. And you can access it by buying a $200 terminal, which isn't available yet. But the interesting thing is, right now, like, everything is going with them. Nothing is against them. Except, so they have few issues, like, astrologers are saying ki sky mein they're doing a lot of... Astronomers said that they're causing a lot of light pollution because of the reflection. So they are working with them. Yeah. But this solves a lot of problems. Like, first, they'll defeat monopolies like Comcast, Verizon, udhar ke. Idhar bhi there's Jio and ye, but we still have a better internet situation. And then these satellites, so the way they work is they have one satellite communicating with you through the phased array antenna, and then they'll communicate with each other via lasers. So, and these satellites have latencies which are lesser than optic fiber. Like, so the main funding they are looking for is coming from the stock market. Yeah, the stock market. You never thought this. So this came as a surprise, yeah, meko bhi. So the reason the stock market people are willing to fund so much is because for them latency means millions of dollars. So I didn't know this. While doing the research, I got into it and I realized that these guys paid $300 million to put a private optical fiber connection from New York to London. Just for this task, and so because they have done the math and that is more profitable than just doing something else.
Got it.
And so Starlink reduces that too. And ye to bas New York se London hai, which is still a shorter distance than New York to some place. It reduces latency by so much. So
fair
enough. While doing the research, I didn't write it here, but the new optic fiber reduced the latency by 5% or something. It was very low. It was already like 60 milliseconds, but udhar se it came to 55 milliseconds.
Okay.
Aisa.
Achha.
And then this will this Starlink situation will reduce the latency by 17%. So imagine the amount of money they are willing to pay, and they are really good. Yeah. And so the reason most of you haven't heard about Starlink is because they give $0 to advertisement and marketing. That is just like classic Elon Musk move.
That's right. Even with the
Cybertruck.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cybertruck,
they had like no.
But come on, it made noise for itself.
Obviously, that's.
We did the marketing.
Exactly, did the marketing.
So the Starlink thing is a direct competition to 5G, and 5G is marketed like everywhere. They have invested more in marketing than I guess the tech itself. I have seen 5G. I mean, I've seen 5G at so many places. Phone makers have forcibly put it in their phones. Like Qualcomm is forcing them to put 5G modems because Qualcomm produces the modems. So
but doesn't the 865 come with a 5G modem?
Like, so it drives the cost up now anyway.
Right.
Because making that 5G modem is hard, and you're supposed to have four antennas just to connect
to the
towers. Yeah, and that is blocked by a tree. Like, imagine if a new tree or a new building comes up near your house and you are no more having the 5G internet connection. And this is something very promising. Like, I don't know why there is not a lot of investment in this, like more than 5G. Because at some point we'll run out of that places to put those towers. Because 5G mein we'll have a tower at line everywhere you look there'll be a eye level needed. Well, everywhere you look there'll be a 5G tower because 5G gets blocked by anything.
Oh my god.
So it's estimated as 100 billion lagega to put all those towers just in United States.
Wow.
And
100 billion. What?
It's gonna take 10 times less. Starlink ka budget is 10 billion pura to put the entire constellation upar.
Wow.
I have no clue how people thought that Starlink is not a good idea and 5G is a great idea. I mean, I was with 5G, come on, I have ideas that will require 5G to be a thing. I mean, for the Smart India Hackathon, I had an idea and they said that unless 5G or something happens, this is not viable. And I'm like, yeah, it makes sense. Yeah, we don't have it. So, and they were just not ready to understand, man. They want something that they can deploy tomorrow.
Advait looks into the future, guys. You can't meet Advait's level.
And imagine the benefits, like, the companies, okay, so these companies are, so all this research while I was doing, this is coffee US ka thing because India mein nahi hai Starlink. Surprise, surprise. And so the thing is, udhar, if you are living in a place, there is basically one provider which is the monopoly udhar ka,
right,
like
local.
One region ka.
Locally.
And so there is Comcast, Verizon, Xfinity or something, yeah. Yeah, and so if you look at the coverage maps now, none of them overlap. So basically they have planned it all. No, none of them overlap. So they have planned out their own boundaries and all of them suck. Like that is what the reviews and everything said.
Dude,
maybe it's better than us or maybe it's not better than us.
I saw an episode of Unbox Therapy and it was comparing, I think it was Lou later only, it was his podcast, and they were comparing data prices all over the world. And I think India was obviously the cheapest. I think it was $0.26 per GB of
India was the cheapest.
Is the cheapest.
Oh, acha. When the way Jio wasn't charging or something, or
what? What? No. Even with Jio, it was like 1 year ago.
Oh, okay. That is nice.
One
so we are living at the.
Yeah, India has the cheapest data prices, and Europe, Canada is I think second or third cheap. I think second or third most expensive. It's really expensive. Data is really expensive.
I remember
in the United States.
I remember there was this video comparing the top 10 speeds in various countries, and the top 3 or 4 were like 20 Mbps, 30 Mbps, and I had 100 Mbps net tummy. And I'm like, why is this my country not on the list, bro? Did you miss something?
Yeah.
And Okay, so coming back to Starlink, so the latency, latency is a big part of this because that is what they are getting paid for. The
exactly.
Speed is, I guess, 1 Gbps up and down, I guess. And this is just the testing phase. Like, there was a tweet Elon Musk made, the tweeting from Starlink, Tessa. And I thought, what is this joke? And tabhi I didn't understand it, but now I get it. Oh, he used that to tweet. So. And
yes.
Then, okay, so the latency from Earth to one of those satellites which is above you is 3.6 milliseconds.
Whoa.
Which is so less. That's mind-blowing. And then...
You have to understand that the satellite is thousands of kilometers away from you.
Mm-hmm.
And then...
Okay, the problem with having that many satellites super is that you can't have one satellite going up and then down again, because if the data
down.
Has to move somewhere else, the data will have to go through from one satellite to another and then vice. So it will have to find the shortest path. So these guys are gonna have to make a new modem system or something like that for that to happen, and routing system basically. But come on, they must have thought it out, वैसे तो. And I don't know, it seems like a cool future कि सब space से जा रहा है data and stuff.
I saw this video on Twitter where I think it was from the SpaceX handle only, where the rocket was essentially where the 60s Starlink satellites were slowly disconnecting from the rocket. It was so cool to watch.
It was amazing.
It was so
I know.
It was so cool to watch. I was like, what is that? Really cool. It's too good.
And these satellites have their own ion thruster, so they can avoid obstacles and stuff udhar. So space debris is a problem sabke liye. So Elon Musk so SpaceX team did address this, and they said that the satellites will destroy 95% of them when they re-enter Earth ke orbit mein. Earth ke atmosphere mein, sorry, fuck, we are making so many mistakes.
Satellites will destroy 95% of what?
Themselves.
Oh damn.
While coming down. So there will be no space debris, like, and even if the ion thrusters break, the satellites will destroy themselves in 5 years or so, 1 to 5 years, which is very less in space time, very less in space ka thing, because satellites take about 100 years because they are so far away,
right,
to get destroyed,
right.
Pura.
Mm-hmm.
So space debris ka problem they did address. Although I have a couple of concerns abhi idhar. I couldn't find any answers to them. What will they do about weather? Because all our data is going up and down,
yeah.
And weather ka kya?
That's right.
So I couldn't find a lot of answers. I saw a subreddit ka question, and then all they had was ki we'll see what happens, and they had a bot reminding them after 6 months ki check it now, kuch hua kaise. So I was like, nothing there.
That's right.
And so, okay, well, I found one bad news, lekin. So when they were trying this re-entry test, ek iska satellite ka, to see if it burns up or not,
yeah,
it almost crashed with the European weather satellite. So the European weather satellite had to change its way or something. So they'll have to be very careful with that. And normally satellites go, they don't collide, so they have humans maneuvering the debris and stuff. But when you have 42,000 of them, there has to be an autonomous system. And these guys have put in the autonomous system as well.
Of course.
But all the satellites are gonna need it. And there is a lot of work, but it is at least more promising than keeping one tower outside your house.
I think it's safer, and you know, I don't know, man, but it's safer from a radiation point of view. I mean, there's not a lot of radiation. I mean, so this is a very small object, and there's obviously the limits and stuff, but still, mm-hmm. I mean, prolonged exposure to, if you live close to a mobile tower, you definitely risk some amount of you know, long exposure damage. I don't know, but I read it in somewhere. You said 5G gets blocked by any building, right?
Any building, so, any tree, anything.
So does it mean it has a high frequency?
Yeah.
Anna?
Although it is way lower than what.
Of course.
If a 5G tower can harm you, then your microwave should kill you. Waisa wala hi hai.
Exactly, yeah, that's the whole thing.
It's very safe.
It is very safe.
I mean, 5G is, everything is safe.
Yeah.
The people who are making these are smart and they want to live too. So if they put killing towers everywhere, they'll get killed too.
Fair enough.
I don't know how people don't understand this. Like, all that talk about,
exactly.
Oh, Wi-Fi is killing you. And yeah.
Right.
If it kills you, it will kill them too. And why would they make something that will kill themselves? Yeah. And this is the most basic argument I can give to a person who doesn't understand the ionization frequency stuff and yeah. But yeah.
That's right.
So yeah, I just had these couple of questions in ka answer meko mila nahi. But still, this seems like a very promising tech. I don't know why.
How do you think the weather would affect signals?
So,
electrical disturbances from thunderstorms?
Yeah,
clouds?
Electrical disturbances and clouds ke saath interference. But what I think is, if there are clouds, they'll shift to something as a low frequency, which doesn't get affected much. It'll lower the speeds, but at least it will give something.
Mm-hmm.
And clouds move continuously, and
right.
The satellite constellation is also moving continuously.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, they'll figure something out.
Course,
maybe they
course,
haven't abhi
course,
tak or something, but I think the future is Starlink. Like, I'm willing to bet on Starlink more than, let's say, 6G. I'll give 5G a short pass as a, but 6G is just not gonna happen, man. Like, it's not coming.
Starlink stock khareed.
Oh, I wish. I was talking to my dad that day, and I'm like, buy Tesla ka stock. And he's just explaining, we can't buy Tesla ka stock idhar reh ke. And I'm like, nahi, buy it. Why can't we? I have a VPN, we can go there.
Tell him to buy Jio ka stock.
Oh, everyone is buying Jioka. And not everyone is buying, everyone is investing in Jioka stuff. Like, it has gotten a lot of foreign investment aajkal, and then there's this Atmanirbhar talk, and then yay. So, good for you, Jio. You're doing good.
Good for you.
Yeah, but you're far from Starlink.
You don't have enough competition. That's why you're doing that.
Oh, huh. And I don't know. I see people still using Vodafone. And so that day, the storm came, right? Mere idhar, I mean, hamare idhar. And so this girl got Vodafone stopped working.
What?
And I'm like, what? Yeah, Vodafone, yeah, Airtel ta pata nahi, stopped working.
I use Vodafone, so like I'm gonna be defensive here. No, but I was using my 4G. Mera Wi-Fi, I think, went down for like a few hours. I was using 4G, it was not fine. Maybe.
Oh, maybe हमारे इधर का कुछ हुआ रहेगा, I don't know, but then I really glad we have this tech which is working even in the harsh environment. Like the winds were really high and stuff like that.
Essentially, we're glad we were born in this time.
Yeah, exactly. We're just glad to have internet there.
Yep, fair enough. Starlink satellites, guys, buy the stock.
Yeah, buy the stock if you can. Come on. Someone's gonna comment, hey, this guy doesn't know how stocks work, and I seriously don't. My friend tries to explain as all this, ki, this went up, this went down, as a, and then she talks with her dad as a, ki, about stocks, and then she comes and tells me, ki, oh, teko pata hai, ye hua, and then it's stocks, like, ye hua. I'm like, what the fuck? Like, amazing, yes. And so, sometime back, I think I subscribed to Google and Apple ka stocks, ka, this is like, and I guess I get these notifications that like, oh, stocks are up today, stocks are down today. I'm like, okay, nice.
I will use that information sometime in the future.
Sometime in the future, yes. Abhi 10 rupees invest karke kya karna hai?
Oh my god, that's right.
Oh, chalo, let's move on to. Haan, go ahead. No, go ahead. So, I don't let you talk, I guess.
No, not at all. I have so many digressive topics. I was gonna. Stocks ka topic nikla tha, so I was gonna say ki, you know, remember that one time when Elon Musk said that his stock was too high? You don't know?
What's the stock right now? I know that tweet, I like that tweet, and I'm like, nah, this guy is just being humble or something, but it made waves as a stock market, I heard.
People lost like thousands of dollars just because of his one tweet.
Oh, they do it every. This guy tweets something and people lose real money. That is sad.
It's really sad.
But should, then I guess
you should
they
not
make
have,
it up. I don't know how stock market works, man.
Should not have that kind of
power. Oh yeah, but you can't like take that power away from him, right?
Nah, you can't. Abhi wo hai uska influence.
Abhi wo hai to hai abhi. And it's not as a power. It's just that the people have put him there,
as a. Yeah, that's right. Cool, let's move on to the next topic. What's the next topic?
Let's move on.
Is it Razer
Blade? Tera topic. Awesome. Yeah, come awesome. On. You seem excited about it.
I'm always excited so, about laptops and desktops and CPUs. Always.
I bought one, I'm not excited. I just buy tech and I'm like, I will not research that tech anymore because kal kuch to naya aega, it's gonna be better than what I have and I'll be sad.
That's
sad or like, yeah.
Exactly what's been happening since I got my laptop, guys. So, Razer Blade. The Razer Blade 2020 laptops got launched, and apparently they are better. They're not better this year. Again, we were talking in the previous episode. Watch the previous episode. The cardio. Ike option aayega.
Editor dalega to aayega varna nahi.
Editor nahi. YouTube wale dalte. Arey 2 minute ka kaam hai. I'll show you later. So, wo dekh lo. Episode dekh lo. Where we talked about how tech has incremental improvements over year. Okay, so yeah. All I'm gonna tell you. Spoiler alert. So this year, Razer Blade has done incremental improvements to their Razer Blade lineup. Razer Blade lineup is essentially their gaming laptop lineup. They have Razer Blade, they have Razer Stealth. Razer Stealth is thinner, lighter, but still good performance. But it is more for, you know, portable gaming. Okay. So this is their proper like gaming laptop where the processors are very powerful, the GPU is very powerful, the battery is small to accommodate, you know, the
cooling system
exactly. And so this year they have two two models, right? So there's a base model and there's an advanced model. And last year what had happened, only the advanced model had the 4K OLED option. And this year even the base model, which starts at $1,600, I mean Razer is very expensive. It's like the MacBook of Windows.
Gaming. Uh-huh.
It's the Apple of Windows.
Yeah.
It's too overpriced. And it's like a very
but
niche.
I saw the review and he said he uses those laptops, Asaki.
Yeah, because
he can't explain it.
Exactly. I told you, it's more about the feel of the laptops.
And feel of the laptops,
it's a very
yeah.
niche, as I said, it's a very niche consumer market, okay? People who want to game, like if you are a gamer, you'll just invest into a desktop, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly.
I never understand these as thick laptops.
Exactly. Exactly.
I'm like, what are you trying to be, portable or high performance?
Exactly, because some laptops are neither portable nor high performance. So it's a very confusing.
Yeah, those
Acer
ka laptops are with those thick ends and needing two power bricks.
Yeah. Oh, and I'm dude, like, holy shit, that was crazy. That one was crazy. I know what I'm talking about. Oh
yeah,
God.
And then there was this one.
It had a mechanical keyboard and stuff.
Yeah, and then there was this one which had as a pipe endings in the laptop ke peeche se, and you could connect a water cooler to it.
I don't know this.
Just buy a gaming PC.
Desktop, exactly.
It's cheaper. You won't lift that monstrosity anywhere.
Oh my God, exactly. But again, the Razer Blade, coming back to it, it's a very niche, product. And
I mean, Razer Blades still look nice and
they look really nice. They look really nice, and they have like, but this time I don't think they have a white version for the advanced model.
They do, I guess. It's for the touchscreen, 4K one.
I'm not sure, but I think the base model has white color. Advanced model doesn't.
Okay, there is a white color. If you have to buy it, then
So it starts at $1,600. Absolute mad lag, but this time the $1,600 version also has 4K OLED option, which is actually very nice. Because last year, as I said, only the advanced model had the 4K OLED, and they have 6 core CPUs in the base model, and 8 core CPUs and NVIDIA super GPUs in the advanced model. And in the advanced model, they have a vapor chamber for thermal stuff. So, how do I explain a vapor chamber? It's essentially
it's a chamber.
So usually cooling systems are made of like copper pipes, right? So the garam hava goes from the CPU to the copper pipes to the fan. But a vapor chamber is literally a small section, an entire section of the motherboard is covered by this gigantic, metal. It's as a cover kar diya. So the fans are here, the two fans are here, they have been covered by this, metal, it's a cover.
I didn't know this.
So it's essentially a small chamber, it's a room on the motherboard. So there's no pipes.
I thought it had something to do with fluid evaporating and taking the heat out.
So vapor chamber is literally a room where all the hot air is, accumulated, and since there are no pipes, it's only pressure doing all the work. And it is so vapor chambers have the pros of a vapor chamber is thermal performance is much better. That is why they have 8 core CPUs in the advanced vapor chamber model. And the con is that you need to make the laptop a little bit motor. So the advanced model with the vapor chamber is 2 millimeters thicker than the one without the vapor chamber.
Yeah, these laptops are specifically for gamers, right? They are meant to be thick.
Yeah.
Because I saw the review and I'm like, oh God, is this something made in 2020? I'm like, I guess I'm not at the gaming market target anyway.
That's right.
You know, we're talking about who's going to use this. Maybe college students might living in dorm rooms and hostels.
But so then again, college students, wo bhi EMI pe lena padega, what next?
Oh no, their parents will pay for it.
Hey, let's not count that. Aisa kuch nahi hota.
Yeah, there are, talking about EMI pay karne wale, I'm one of those.
But
I don't.
The thing is.
So I remember when my JEE was going on tabhi uske pehle, and there was this Flipkart ka big billion sale aisa.
Those are very
there was this group of kids who were I guess rich, I don't know, and they bought this Acer Predator, sab same laptops kharide, and so they weren't allowed to open those I guess or something, and they just kept it udhar aisa sare 6 boxes aisa Acer Predators just waiting to be opened once their JEE is over. Wow. Kya tempting hota hoga.
Oh my god, Acer, yeah. But Acer I know what you're talking about. It's a decent lineup. Predator is a pretty good
lineup. Oh no, they had those acha wala gaming wala. I remember, I don't remember the exact model, but yeah, they were meant to be gaming laptops.
That's nice.
So yeah, Razer Blade 15, guys. If you are rich, buy it.
Buy it. That's literally the entire point. If you're rich,
I mean, I don't get it. Why won't you buy a gaming? Let's think it Razer ke perspective se. Why would someone buy a Razer Blade 15? 15, right?
Huh.
A 15 over a gaming PC.
Okay, fine.
Equivalent so, powered game. So let's just assume the gaming PC is gonna be cheaper.
Right.
Is that the case?
It is definitely.
But with the monitor and stuff, monitor, keyboard, and yeah, will it definitely be cheap?
100% and better performance, dude. Come on.
Okay.
I'll tell you what you can build with a $1,600 budget, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You can build a third generation, the Ryzen 7 3700X, amazing, awesome motherboard. You can overclock the CPU, there are graphics card, aram se suno ye.
Which graphics card can you buy? Lekin?
I'm not sure if you can buy the 2070 Super. But
okay, so you're still in the 60s range. It's not in the 80s range, right?
What?
2080. The graphics card. I thought with 1600 I have.
No, no, not. Not buddy, 2080. No, so ka graphics card.
Exactly. So,
$900.
If you put $900 to it and then. You have around kita left.
$700. $700. Na? Tumhara nahi. 700 में से आधे से ज़्यादा तो तेरा CPU में चला जाएगा. 8 core, AMD का.
How much is it?
350 to 450.
Okay. That's nice.
It's decent, but no. I wouldn't go with a 2080. If I have a 60.
That will be a bottleneck, I guess.
It won't be a bottleneck. It'll be a bottleneck in the budget. So a well-balanced build would be 2060 Super or 1660 Ti if you don't want the ray tracing stuff. So I would go CPU though, I would prioritize. So I would go with an 8 core CPU 3700X, you can overclock it. Uske saath motherboard bhi aaram se aa jayega. And you can even go with some cheap water cooling also you can put in $1,600.
You know, I think you should pay more for cooling.
You
like buy a 6 core CPU and then use that money for cooling.
That is quite viable and I would actually recommend that.
Oh, so there you go, Razer Blade 15.
Razer Blade 15. If you have the money, buy it. If you don't have the money, go with the.
There's this YouTuber, Sara DG, and she does a lot of laptop stuff and PC stuff, and she just got into Windows. From Mac.
Sarah,
why would you do that? Sarah DG.
Okay.
And so I liked what she said about gaming laptops and stuff. So she said if you're living at the same place, gaming at the same place, buy
right.
a PC.
That's right.
If you're traveling and you're gaming, buy something thin, put the settings down for the game. You don't need ultra graphics on that small screen anyway.
True.
So if you do come on, I mean, you're gonna have to play 30 or something, 30 FPS. But if you're traveling that much, ki you need a laptop for gaming, then maybe you
exactly.
will have to compromise somewhere because
exactly.
having a thick laptop will break your back if you're carrying it that much.
That's right.
And I guess one scenario where I would give it a edge over it is for college students because they need the laptop in college and then ghar pe bhi wagaira. So I guess I don't know, you're gonna have to make some compromises.
Fair enough. So apparently, dude, on Amazon, you're getting the processor, 8-core 3700X, with the CPU cooler and the motherboard for $600.
That's a steal.
That's a steal.
Yeah.
That's crazy. And the motherboard is not bachches, huh? Must or like
yeah, so.
Must.
I mean, we are, I it's been so long since I have done this PC market wala ye, because the last time I built a PC, that is when I did this, and that was like 10th standard ke baad. So that's a, and I'm in second year engineering now, so do the math. Yeah. So
at $600 top of the line, you'll be gaming at almost 100 FPS at AAA like this, easily, so not too
bad. Or buy an Xbox.
Hey, you can't game at 100 FPS on an Xbox.
Yeah, but you won't need 100 FPS on an Xbox. I mean,
what?
If you're playing on an Xbox, I'm pretty sure you won't need 100 FPS. The TV and stuff, they can't put 100 FPS up anyway.
Hey, you can put a monitor, na? 144 Hz.
Okay, you're buying a 144 Hz monitor and then asking me if I'm gaming PC low ki laptop low. I mean, come on, man.
Fair enough. Oh my god.
Gaming on TVs, damn. I don't know how you guys play with it. Anyone, like, playing Call of Duty competitive on a TV?
I haven't played competitive Call of Duty, but I've played, like, you know, local multiplayer on a TV.
Haan, tabhi to latency same hai na.
Haan, that is fine.
But it doesn't matter, aisa.
Haan, it doesn't.
Dono ka. Dono ki lag rahi hai bas, basically.
The I remember, holy shit. This was the first time I went to like a foreign country. Okay. I was staying at my cousin's place in Kuwait, and they had a PS3 at the time. This was in 2009.
Okay.
2013. And I was staying at the place, and we used to play COD. And that was the first time I had ever properly played on a console. Okay. And we were 5 people. Two, me and my brother, and there's three of my cousins there in that house. So we had to take turns because there were only 4 controllers.
Okay. You still had 4 controllers?
Yeah, we still had 4 controllers. Okay, so we split the screen.
I thought taking turns, so ek bar GTA 5 khelenge hum as a single person.
We were, no, they're rich that way. So they had a huge screen, and that not, and it was 55 inch only, but mere standard se tab wo bahut bada tha. And we used to like divide into like 4 parts and play with each other.
Oh.
And sometimes against each other. So you couldn't look into the other person's screen.
Achha, okay.
It was right beside yours. So like
so that's what?
Almost a retro.
That's a 27 inch screen for everyone, right?
Yeah, but we're sitting like very far away.
But still that is
Yeah, good.
That
enough.
It was a
satisfactory gaming experience. What can I say?
More than satisfactory. I haven't played on a big display kabhi.
Okay.
Ha, nahi, never. It was PSP then. It's 21. I mean, my monitors are 21 inches, so.
That's a fair size.
Yeah, for, I mean, going greater than that would be stupid because ek table pe rehta
hai wo. That's right.
So, yeah.
चलो फिर
पुफ एनीवे रेजर ब्लेड 15 से इधर आ गए हम दैट इज सो अतिकन अद्वैत द लास्ट टाइम वी हैड प्लान फोर व्हाट फोर टॉपिक्स एंड देन वी शिफ्टेड टू 8 जस्ट इन द पॉडकास्ट ऐसे एंड
ऑलवेज रूम फॉर इंप्रोवाइजेशन
हां भाई सो एनीवे द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक वी हैव इज Let's do remove China apps. Productivity wala end mein rakhta.
Yes, remove China.
So remove China apps. I mean.
So this was.
Okay, I have notes on this. So
sure,
I guess
sure.
Do the introduction. Introduction.
So what happened was Sonam Wangchuk is a scientist and Uspit 3 Idiots ka movie inspired hua hai. And he makes YouTube videos also, and his YouTube videos are very fun to watch. They're informative and they make a lot of sense. Okay. So what he proposed was, he had this whole theory that China has, monopoly over over the manufacturer of most of the products that that a lot of countries buy, right? My phone, the phone I'm recording on is made in China, guys. So you can understand. And
mine is
right.
Made in Vietnam.
Yeah, he's
so
yeah.
I'm safe.
So yeah, that's his theory. Ki matlab, we are all essentially, you know, indebted by China. We cannot be, you know, self-dependent for manufacturing a lot of consumer-grade products because one, they are cheap. China se aate saste hote, and two, they have the technology, they have the resources, they have the factories, they have the population to, you know, support the manufacture of so many, you know, goods. And he proposed ki we should stop using products from China so that hamara khud ka economy badhega, which makes sense. He also proposed that we should delete all the apps that are made in China that we have installed on our phone. Okay, and to facilitate this, he made an app which deletes Chinese apps. Okay, and he put that on the Play Store. Right now, it got 1 million downloads within 24 hours or 72 hours, something like that. But it was a hit. Okay, all the mainstream Instagram influencers were making videos where they were propagating people and encouraging people to hashtag delete China apps. It was trending. And then Google deleted it from the Play Store. Okay, now when I read this headline, I was like, I saw this coming, and I was not surprised that they deleted it. Because one, it is directly affecting other apps. Like, Play Store will not, it is common sense. Play Store will not keep an app in its database that will encourage people to delete other apps that it also keeps on its database. You know what I mean?
I guess,
exactly.
I mean, that's common sense, but, you know, huh, I mean, okay, now that you said it, yeah. My point was, they should have looked in the privacy. I mean, okay, it sounds like an absurd rule unless you think as a Google ke side se ki they have a business to run. I mean,
have a business to
for
run.
Us, it's like, huh, it's just deleting apps. Why are you deleting the apps that deleting? I mean, it's not gonna hurt you that much.
For
but
us,
for
us, like
them, it's, yeah. And this happened with that Karen Minatica video also. Everyone is like, why deleted it? Why they deleted it? When? If you are using a platform, YouTube, Google, Play Store, you have to play by their rules. It's
That's
as
right.
simple as
exactly,
that.
Exactly, yeah.
If you don't play by their rules, they will remove you. They didn't
That's
remove the account, they just removed the app. So,
exactly.
I don't think they terminated the developer
and
account or something like that.
Keeping in mind that it was that app was deleting TikTok, which is also made in China. TikTok creates a lot of revenue.
Lot of revenue for Google, man.
Mad lad revenue. TikTok pagal jaisa revenue create karta hai Google ke liye. And if another app is deleting that app from people's phone, then they will definitely not support it.
But what do you think about this movement? Anti-China wala.
It makes a lot of sense. It does make a lot of sense.
Yeah, it does make a lot 100%. Of sense. Like, I don't normally share stuff on my story unless it's about me or something.
Right.
Like, my Instagram is only about me mostly.
Right.
But this stuff makes sense.
It
and
makes
I have
a lot
done,
of sense.
I have done enough research to know ki, yeah, this is happening.
It is happening.
100%. And this is my first-hand experience. So China has this law where you have to share all the data that you collect with the Chinese government, which is not accepted. Like, why would you need all that data if not for surveillance? And
really?
Surveillance is China.
Like,
yeah.
So
there is a law. And yeah, so
the apps
I had
that collect information?
Apps, everything that TikTok collects, China can access it. The Chinese government. They have this law key. If you collect data, you'll have to share it with us when we ask about it.
For app developers in China, that's the law, right?
Everything. Anything that collects data.
Anything that collects data. Oh.
So they I guess, okay, I might be wrong, I might be thoda off, but there is this ye ki Chinese government can access everything. And
fair enough.
Alibaba se the cheap ass store,
it's
I had
Amazon.
Ordered a watch. Huh. So I use an Amica watch and I had ordered uska strap. And so when I was getting those emails, normally I'm, so this practice is so common of encrypting emails is that you never notice it unless you click the more option. There it is written, it is encrypted. Alibaba ke emails are not encrypted. And that was kind of a shocker, aisa ki why would you not encrypt emails? And then I looked into it and then this China ka stuff came up and And so you are giving your information to a market that will use it in a wrong way, and they have shown it. And
potentially
when you
wrong way. Without your consent.
Yeah. Without your, and the data is theirs.
It is
basically.
They own it.
It is
when
theirs.
You download the app, you agree to the terms and conditions. That is one of the terms and conditions.
Yeah, which is, and okay, I am all with there should be trade between countries, and trade shouldn't stop. And then the fact that we have this global market, it is an amazing thing because it can literally lift countries out of poverty.
Seriously.
But when you must realize that the entire world is dependent on that one country to get everything, and they have managed to do it. So if, and everybody is realizing it, Samsung, Google, Samsung has the largest factory in India now. Apple has started producing phones in India.
I think the iPhone 8, XR are being
and
produced
in India. Yeah, some of them, they can't, I don't know if they have published.
I read an article. I don't know about that, but there was an agreement ki matlab iPhone 8 and iPhone XR, because these two phones are very popular in India. So, ye toh phones
yeah.
ka, haan.
And so everybody is realizing it. It is not just us. It is the entire West and the people who are already dependent on China. They're realizing it and they're pulling out fast.
They have to.
If they get stuck for too long, they could lose the entire company. I mean, what is the company without the production facility? And so everybody is realizing it except us. So it was not technically a debate. I saw a friend of mine post this case, the anti-China movement is stupid because it's like, so her points were the reason we are doing this is because of the West, and that when they were getting cheap labor, they were all China. Now they are not getting cheap labor. They are like not China. Which kind of made sense, but then there is more to it. All that money that we are giving them is being used in a wrong way. I guess immoral way. It is their money, they can use it anyway. So I watched this video where they explained what China is basically doing in a gist. So when countries need loans, these guys give them all the money they need.
Bahut scam.
To build ports and
that's right.
And when they can't pay the loans, they can't pay them back, and they say that, theek hai, mat pay karo, but we'll operate that port or airport that way.
I read the same article.
Yeah, I know, it was a video, Polymatter or some channel. It was a video, it was a really nice video. And so I just say it because it had nice animations. So, and they take control of the port, and that land is there, and they set up military bases and stuff with it. So basically that part of the country is gone.
Is theirs, yeah. I think one of the, there is an area in Africa that is basically operated by China. It is essentially a part of China only now, almost.
They just gave it up.
No, they didn't give it up, but they did exactly this. So they learned
Strategy basically.
It's a military strategy in some ways.
And they are pushing borders everywhere. Hong Kong, India cover border and stuff. And so,
borders,
I don't know what that party is up to. No one will ever know. It's a game so big that no one has the 100% registered in their mind. But
what's going on.
It is, even if all this is false, even if China is not planning any of this, is it not good that you're independent of someone? It is always better to be independent than be dependent and then getting caught in a situation where we are helpless. And okay, so another concern was, hum bolte hai ki karenge, but kya hota hai, kal hum wapis wo kar denge, ki wapis China
pe.
Before I address that, there was this anti-China movement, it was sub-Chinese, he's a fake though. No, don't throw it away. You have already given them the money. Now fucking use it.
That's
so,
right.
And we are dependent on them, and we don't have products that will compete with theirs. So here's what we can do right now. We must be aware of what we are buying. If you're buying something, that's you just it. Have a look. It is made in China. Okay, you bought a Chinese product. Try and reduce a lot of stuff. Like, if you're buying something that can be bought with something that is made in India,
if you can exchange
then go
it,
for it. Exactly. And I'm not saying if the Indian product is not... If the Indian product is
quality.
So much bad, if it is on par, tabhi kharido. If the Indian product is so much bad, as consumers, you have rights to. I mean, it's all yours. Ki go with
that's
the Chinese product,
that's
but
right.
Don't underestimate India because
that's right.
I guess Indians have pulled off as a pretty amazing miracles.
They have, and
there will be a point where this. Where Indian products will be better than Chinese products, like 100%. You don't go to Alibaba to buy
100%
TVs and stuff. You
exactly.
go to Flipkart or Amazon
exactly.
because these products are inherently better than the
right.
one Chinese offering.
Right.
So the same thing will happen. You just have to wait a little. You just have to be conscious about what you're buying. Just
right. You guys remember Micromax?
Conscious.
When Micromax was a thing, yeah, that was Indian, and that died
yeah.
because of Chinese products coming in because of Vivo. It died. OnePlus was one of the reasons Micromax died.
Yeah, but then the Micromax phones were really bad.
Actually bad, yeah. I had a Micromax phone way back. That was
my mom had the Micromax phone. It was a disaster.
It was a bad phone.
See, there are iPhones. They are good. iPhones, Pixels, flagships. Okay, don't call me out for that. They were mid-tier phones. They were bad phones. They were really bad phones. They're Nokia 3310, and then there was Micromax. Micromax, Micromax is the reason we don't have Indian phones, I guess.
Oh my god, yeah, that's right.
But yeah, okay,
is
so.
Is Redmi a Chinese company? Xiaomi?
Yeah, Xiaomi is a Chinese company. Yeah.
Ah, man.
Their entire model. They are in a bit of trouble, I guess. I mean, they are surviving fine, but. So what happened is, it is the basic Amazon wala concept. You give away products as item cheap price pe, and then you make up money services pe.
Right.
So it worked
yeah.
in China because there are no Google services. So Redmi provided
right.
their own as a Xiaomi. But bahar they had Android. So
right.
they were making low margins on phones wagera aise.
Right.
So anyway, we are distracting a bit from topics here. So. My point is, just look at what you buy. If there is an Indian equivalent, which is as good as the Chinese product or better,
mm-hmm.
take that. Of course, if it's better, you'll already take that. And it's not just you have to buy Indian. Buy any other country's products. Like, as long as the market is diverse, it is fine. As long as one country tries to take all of it, it becomes
it.
Bad.
That's
it's like a monopoly wala concept.
You can't give them monopoly essentially. Try
yeah, exactly.
Put your eggs in different baskets essentially.
Baskets, yeah, exactly. And World Trade is a really amazing thing that happened after I don't know what. But now is the time you act that way. And Chinese apps suck.
They suck.
They have bad ads. They have fucking notifications that interrupt. And I don't know what those notifications are. There are amazing alternatives,
yeah.
just that the non-techie people have these app names
in
their head, they'll keep using the bad versions. Cam
yeah.
scanner ke liye
yeah.
Adobe Scan hai.
I use Adobe
there
Scan,
is,
it is so much better than
I
Cam
use
scan.
Adobe, I start,
so
nahin, I switched a month ago and Adobe Scan is so much better.
So good.
That is what I'm saying, and these apps don't have enough coverage abhi tak. And maybe
it's
this
really
moment.
Surprising.
I've seen so many people use UC browser. Chrome comes installed with your phone.
Who uses UC browser? Why do people use UC? I don't understand.
I don't know. UC browser is directly connected to porn somehow.
What?
Instantly that...
Really?
No. It's not. Mere dimag mein.
Achha, samjha humko. That's the brand image. Anyway.
Yeah, that's the brand image. I mean, China. This is coming from a guy who knows the ins and outs of app development. And... Trust me when I say Chinese, okay, they do work what they advertise. They scan the pages,
mm-hmm.
they do the browsing. But so do other apps, and do it way better. you don't have to deal with ads, you don't have to have that scanned with cam scanner page, mm-hmm. you don't have to deal with bad notifications. I say bad, there bad is probably the least disturbing word that I could tell. Say
it's an understatement. About the,
yeah. And so, see, these apps were already there, but you are still using the Chinese ones. So the same way Indian products and the products as a dusre market, not just India, the other market ka products, they will improve with time. You just have to keep an eye out. Because there were better apps and we never knew about these. Even I got to know ki Adobe Scan itna acha hai a few months back.
Ago.
So just open your eyes. That is the thing.
That's right. Also, did you know that there was a TikTok alternative? There was an Indian TikTok alternative called Mitro.
Yeah,
apparently that app also got deleted.
Yeah, or so the reason
that was a different it reason.
I don't know the reason, but I read this article and it had the title TikTok's privacy policy is concerning while Mitro doesn't have one. And it was like, what? You released an
that
app competing TikTok without a privacy policy.
It is exactly the reason it got deleted. It had some issues like at the time of, you know, some terms and
conditions. The code was bought from some Pakistan. I read that.
600 rupees or something.
No, 2600 rupees.
2600 rupees.
So you create an app having a name of the most advertised dialogue, Mitro, and you steal a code from Pakistan. I have nothing against Pakistan. You guys are cool and all. It's just that the irony in that.
The irony, guys. Oh my god. Very funny.
There are better products you can look for.
Apparently there is a Mitro TV app right now on the platform.
I guess someone just changed their name to Mitro TV the advertisement.
I guess.
Phew. So much ranting about China. We are not saying you should be...
I think it is the real one. It has 5 million plus downloads. So what? I guess it's back on the Play Store.
Someone made the privacy policy, I guess. Someone had to stay up an entire night to make a privacy policy. Let's hope they didn't steal the TikTok wala.
This is really funny.
Anyway, so I had to make this point pehle, but I guess now is the time. We are not saying you have to be 0% dependent on China. That is not possible, I guess.
That's not possible. I mean,
we have come to a point where that's not possible.
Theory and practical.
We are talking about practice. Yeah, they say kya bolte hai, boycott China, but it's 100% nahi hone wala.
Maybe over a
and
period of time, it is possible to bring it the number close to zero, or at least equivalent to what we are depending on other countries, you know?
Yeah. And we can't just remove one country from the market, even they need the cash and yen. So think about their side too, even they need the cash and they need everything too. But we are depending on them so much ki without them we can't make a phone.
That's right. An entire market is empty without them. That should not
happen. That should not happen. And yeah, we can be dependent on them, but if they go tomorrow, if China just says ki fuck you, tumhare sath business nahi karna hame, it should not hurt our market to the point it becomes stagnant.
If tomorrow China says ki abhi OnePlus band ho gaya and tum logo ko koi software updates nahi milega,
there are other phones to compete na filhal ke liye, but what happens
but
when
main khareed liya na, mera to lag gaya abhi, that's what I'm trying to say.
Okay, you're saying your wala. I thought you're giving ki China ne wo ban kar diya, so we still have Samsung, we still have ye wagera. Sorry, this is not planned, guys, come on.
If they say ki are humne OnePlus ban kar diya, you won't get service, you won't get updates, you won't get anything, you won't get parts. That's a problem.
Yeah,
it's a genuine problem and that should not happen. And they are aware and they're capable of doing it. Agar wo log ne agar parts bhejna ban kar diya, I have nothing. I can't.
Nobody has nothing.
Yeah, exactly. Nobody has nothing.
Nobody has nothing.
So that should not happen.
Yeah, I mean, be dependent. I guess it comes down to that one sentence ki, everything is good in a limit. Waisa wala.
Mm.
Overdoing
everything,
something.
Everything in excess is poison.
Yeah, everything in excess.
I remember writing this. So when I was in school, board ke upar har hafte ek naya line likha hota tha.
Oh, and so you were the guy.
No,
how do you
I
get
was,
stuck with teachers and stuff, man? This
I
podcast.
I asked myself the same question every day. I remember writing anything in excess is poison. That was one saying that I wrote on the board. उसके पहले मैं उसके अलावा कुछ नहीं लिखा है वो एक लिखा था पता नहीं मैम ने मुझे उस दिन मुझे मैम ने बोला बोला तो लिख दे तब
ओह सो यू हैड टू कम अप विद दैट
आई डिडंट कम अप विद दैट
सी ओके द टीचर हां
मैम ने दिया
दैट इज सच अ अमेजिंग टू कम अप विद ऐसा फॉर अ 10th स्टैंडर्ड किड और समथिंग
आई वाज 6th स्टैंडर्ड व्हेन आई रोट इट
या ओके दैट इज इवन मोर
बट नो आई डिड नॉट कम अप विद दैट बट या एनीथिंग एल्स इज पॉइजन
या सो
अवॉइड सो व्हाट कैन पीपल डू टू लाइक टू व्हाट कैन पीपल डू राइट नाउ
So okay. I guess we can help you. That's okay. You're saying. I thought you were asking me.
No. What can people do? Okay. Like you know, decrease.
So see, first, the easiest thing to do is replacing their apps.
Replace apps.
So I'll make sure there is a. I read an article. It was an amazing article. The most famous Chinese apps and their better alternatives.
Better alternatives.
Okay. So. TikTok was on their list, but I guess TikTok ka main power is their user base, so you can't really do much about it. You're gonna have to be with them if you want those videos. But baki sabka, you can replace them and there are better alternatives. And I did it. I replaced Cam Scanner, iske saath, kya bolte hain?
Adobe
Scan ke saath. And there was this, and I replaced ShareIt. ShareIt. I hated ShareIt already, and I found AirDrop. Android करके एक ऐप है हाँ एंड सो एंड्रॉइड वर्क्स बेटर हैज जीरो एड्स आई नो दे आर नॉट टेकिंग माई डेटा इवन इफ दे आर इट्स नॉट ऑन अ लेवल वेयर ShareIt took एंड देन व्हेन आई ओपन ShareIt डू यू नो ShareIt का मेन थिंग वॉज शेयरिंग स्टफ And
yeah.
Now it has become a social media somehow.
It has become social media. It is very it's the worst app on the Play Store. Literally the worst
app. Yeah, so I use these two apps. TikTok is still there on my phone, so yeah.
Same. But what we can do is we can keep TikTok and Mitro uploaded or downloaded on your phone. We can do that. And see, there has to be in terms of you know these big fat apps like TikTok. There has to be a more gradual transition. So that's what happened with Instagram and TikTok, right?
Yeah.
When TikTok came into existence, instantly sub
Facebook and Instagram. Facebook and
exactly.
Instagram is a better
instantly,
example.
Instantly, huh, that's a much better example. Instantly switch nahi hua. Over a period of, you know, 4 years, 5 years, people started noticing Instagram. And now Instagram has monopoly over Facebook, right?
Mm-hmm. I mean,
that's
I guess.
It does. It definitely does.
There's
a lot more money in Instagram than Facebook today. Even though Facebook is still, are it dude, 100%. Which influencer is on Facebook? Even if they are,
they don't use it.
Exactly. So there is a lot of money in Facebook still. A lot of people still use Facebook. It's good. I mean, it's good for businesses. It's good for YouTubers. Bowen Baum started on Facebook.
Yeah.
He started off from Facebook. So that's what I'm saying. But then again, aaj zyada paisa Instagram. So that's how we can do a gradual transition from certain apps because they have, you know.
The monopoly. But TikTok is not just about India. I mean, I hate Indian TikTok scene. You can go on record as Advait hate Indian TikTok scene. I love what the Western creators are doing with it. And everyone except those. I mean, Indian TikTok scene, and I'm talking about that one particular cringe market. There are some amazing Indian creators, there is this line between those cringy TikToks and those amazing TikToks which Indians are creating.
There is no in between. There is no gray area.
Yeah.
In Indian
yeah.
TikTok, you know, it's either very good or very bad. It's as of now, it's like that, and it's
TikTok has brought up some amazing creators because there is that limit. You have this. short amount of time which is limited, you have to make the samne wala person laugh. And I'm just talking about comedy because that
not
is
even,
the main
fair
thing.
Fair enough. Or in a broad, more, in a more broader sense, give them value. Okay.
Yeah.
It could be any, you know, comedy,
anything,
entertainment,
yeah.
Information, just give them value.
Exactly.
15
and so,
seconds.
50 or 60, whatever. Doesn't 15 matter.
Be,
it's just
two
a limited
modes, so,
time.
There's two modes. Uh-huh. 15 bhi hota and 60 bhi hota. You can choose.
Achha, 15, okay.
15.
Yeah. I haven't made a TikTok, so I don't know.
I have.
So yeah, I mean TikTok is a really good app, except what is its origins are, and it has brought out a lot of creators as well.
That's
so
right.
Yeah, and TikTok TikTok ka main feature is its users. Okay, there are a lot of users who are making amazing content, so it's hard to replace. It's hard to replace humans. As well.
Again,
but
the,
there's gonna be a new app. Come on, Mark Zuckerberg thought there won't be. A, I mean, Mark, kya bolta? We thought there's not gonna be the next Facebook, Instagram, aaya. And then
sad.
Yeah,
hey,
yeah.
You
so
know what? I feel Snapchat was the mediator between Facebook and Instagram.
Yeah, Instagram stole from Snapchat. And
yeah, yeah. Oh man.
And if it wasn't for from Snapchat messing up and Instagram capitalizing on its messing up. It would have been Snapchat. I still use Snapchat, Lekin. I love it.
I have Snapchat for no reason.
Just taking your data.
Oh man. But yeah. That's the remove Chinese app, guys. That's the controversy.
Yeah, that's the controversy.
But
deleted,
not gonna be bad. But that's how you can help. Funsuk, Sonam Bang. Sonam Bang. So it makes a lot of sense, guys. You can definitely just
and that's smart. I mean,
he's very smart.
I see people just countering as a smart logo ka opinion just because someone has to do it. And yeah, you should counter. I'm not saying you shouldn't. You should counter them. You should think before believing anything you see on Instagram or any social media. Fact checking should be taught in schools abhi to. But that is a smart guy you're talking about. I mean, uska dimag nahi kharab hai ki he's just like, hey, ban kar China. It's like, give me money, ban China. No, he's not doing that. He's really smart. And kuch to soch ke hi bol raha hai. Just have a look. Give him 10 extra minutes.
Haan, that's right.
Yeah.
Watch his video. His video is really nice.
Yeah. And he explains it really well.
That's right.
Whew. Talking about controversies is fun.
Yeah. Now, I thought
we would go to YouTube versus TikTok. I don't want to go there.
There's been enough people talking about it.
Keep it to carrying that.
Yeah.
So the final topic is not related to tech. Come on, we know this last two episodes have been major related.
Knowing both of us, we might just link to tech. But
yeah. Rakshita, this is for you, I guess. I don't know. Wo hamesha hamara naam leti hai kaisa? Productivity ka baat karte hain. So we are gonna talk about productivity and how to stay focused and stuff vagera. If you don't
welcome
like
to,
this,
welcome to the Ranveer show, guys.
Oh
my god.
So yeah, so we're gonna talk about how we stay focused. I guess I don't know. I am working pura lockdown. I took
personally,
1 week break. Uske hisab se.
Dude, you have no clue. But for the first almost 2 months of the lockdown, I was I had near to zero productivity. Okay, because legit, I could not, because the lockdown destroyed my sleep cycle. Okay, 2 days into the lockdown, I was sleeping at 6 a.m. No, I was sleeping at 3 a.m., waking up at 4 p.m.
4 p.m.?
Yeah. I was sleeping at 3 a.m., waking up at least, but I was not waking up before 1 p.m. 2 days into the
okay.
So, and that continued until after Ramzan, because Ramzan, jaise Ramzan aaya, main 3 baje so nahi sakta. I can't sleep at 3.
Khana khana hai.
Exactly, I have to eat. And then I used to sleep at 6 o'clock and wake up at something crazy. Yeah, I used to sleep the whole day. And that
how you know, matlab, you didn't feel much as a Ramzan ka na?
Exactly. And I'm a morning person. I really like to wake up early. Okay. And waking up at 4 o'clock did not put me in a very productive mood at all.
Oh, okay.
So I have only been productive since the end of Ramzan, which is like what, 3 weeks?
I don't know. Mera productivity skyrocketed. Jaise ye start
hua. That's really nice.
Because, okay, so I guess the people who know me, they don't know ki how much of a ye college is. Time consumer aisa mera.
Oh, I hate.
I love college. I love going to college. I love meeting friends. I love the cultural environment. I love ye. No, I trust me. This is not ye ki I hate college. This is
that's
I love college. It's just
point.
That it takes a lot of time. Come on. But I had pura din mere paas. And what I did in 2 hours, now I have 24 to do them. Aise.
Exactly. It's real nice.
Starting
that is...
it was like making aisa pura. Complete modules of an app, ek sitting mein stuff वगैरह ऐसे, but surely it went down काफी ज़्यादा because I am a social person काफी ज़्यादा and I like to meet people and they are as a refreshment mera and I was put in this jail basically and so
right.
It went down and then we lost a couple of competitions वगैरह so that was a turn off. So the first thing I would say is if you're feeling ऐसा कि you have done पहले थोड़ा बहुत and you're just not in a mood to do anything, don't do it. Take a week's break. I took a week's break and it solved everything. Aisa. Mera sleep schedule theek ho gaya and sab theek ho gaya.
The thing with productivity, the word productivity is overused. And the thing is we put pressure on ourselves. And that is the exact reason that stops us.
Haan, exactly.
It's very ironic.
I know. And so instead of, so I was reading this book Atomic Habits karke and it made a lot of sense tabhi. Willpower won't take you off aisa distance jyada. Willpower is sabka, even the strongest person ka willpower is very low compared to what changing your environment can do. So basically here, I have some thoda notes ki how you should stay focused. Pehle toh you should be separated. If you are distracted by your phone or something, keep it thoda dur. Not aisa dusre room mein, keep it thoda dur. Because
I need to keep some charge. Speaking of
the phone. Did it turn off?
No, it did not. I luckily opened WhatsApp and WhatsApp pe dikhata if my phone is on low battery. Luckily I opened it.
So basically my point is, if you have a distraction, keep it dur. Create friction between your distraction and you.
That's right.
And then you should map your tasks. I'm not saying calendar pe calendar banao each hour ka. Just write ki aaj main ye karega. Aaj main ko, I have to write this article. I have to edit this picture. I have to do this. Just sa thoda vaguely. And then basically the game is create inconvenience with your distraction and make the process that you want to achieve something
smoother.
As smooth as possible.
Yeah, that's right.
And
I guess it's a bit of
okay, so I'll complete and then I'll give it to you. So create, the last thing is create as a end time ki 6 baj gaya to main kuch nahi karne wala uska. I know that sounds counterproductive, but your mind won't be racing ki ye khatam hone ke baad hi main ja paunga and ye, and that will just create more anxiety and you won't do it in the end.
Also, if you put like a time limit to your task, you think with your subconscious brain and that is why exams have a time limit, right?
Yeah,
That is one of the reasons that exams have a time limit. So you think more efficiently if you have a time limit. If you think ki yaar mujhe 6 baje se pehle complete karna, then there is a lot of chance that most of your work will be completed by 16.
Yeah, and there is a saying, work expands the time you give it, vaisa.
If you think ki wo mere paas bahut time hai, khatam ho jayega,
nahi hone wala. It will.
Humans are big procrastinators. We are professional procrastinators.
And we are wired to do it. It's not like hum aisa bane hain.
Exactly.
Abhi.
Can't help it. That's right. Your evolution does not push you to edit videos. It pushes you to rest and eat.
That is the next important thing. You have to sleep well.
Oh.
Anytime you sleep, anytime you wake up, give yourself a good 6 to 8 hours as well.
100% you have to sleep. I can't stress
and
this enough.
And once you have ऐसा set timetable ना कि मैं इधर सोऊंगा ही रात को नींद आने लगता है अपने आप and it happened with me ऐसा कि if it's 11:30-12 मेरे को अपने आप नींद आ जाता है वगैरह I just complete जो करना है थोड़ा बहुत लिखने writing task में नहीं है and the next thing is workspace so have a clean workspace which is good looking because you have to come there every day
but then again, that is also subjective some people like it messy. Some people don't mind messy. So maybe you and me, I like my workspace really clean.
Like, even I like my workspace really clean. The people who like it messy, it's just that they don't care. It's not that main jaan bujh ke clean hai to messy kar dunga.
वैसा नहीं.
I haven't met anyone that वैसा कुछ होगा.
वैसा मत करो. But I don't know. Maybe it could be. Maybe they don't mind. Maybe they don't mind. Maybe their productivity.
It's not affected my personal tips as well.
same.
I watch a couple of channels ki jab bhi main aisa unproductive rehta I just watch them and same. They'll give me some tips as a to do list wagera ka and ye so there is this app Notion karke I think I'm just advertising it as a right and left everyone should use it it is a good looking app and it can be whatever you want it can be a to do list tracker journal anything and it is just good looking app waisa ekdam zyada so you should use that and you should do stuff that will please you aisa a good looking workspace will please you a good looking to do list will please you aisa so you should keep rewards aise for yourself ki ye task complete ho gaya
and exactly also when you're delegating tasks what I did for the first few days of the lockdown was I wrote 3 tasks that I had to complete on a notepad.
Yeah, exactly.
3 main tasks. And I killed almost all of them. Okay, I completed almost all of them. So that was what helped me be productive. After that, there was too much to write. Suddenly I got a lot of work I'm still completing a lot of work, but I'm doing it without the to-do list. So I didn't train myself, but that could help you guys. You could train yourself to make a mental to-do list. You could start by writing it down and then as you complete this to-do list, make the tasks easy and
small as modules mein basically.
Yeah, exactly. In small chunks. Samjha. You can't bite off more than you can chew, essentially.
Yeah, and it's like this. Your to-do list item shouldn't be write a book. It should be write a page or write a chotu sa aisa. Matlab smallest possible task that can be done post time period.
Exactly. It has to be as specific as possible. You can't
possible.
Say you can't say do a workout today. You have to be like do 10 burpees, 10 crunches from 7 to 7:30. That's specific. That's a to-do list. That's a goal. To-do list. Exactly.
And then keep we are talking about workspace abhi toh, so keep aisa healthy snacks ya water around. You shouldn't be going somewhere. Ha, exactly. Even I have a bottle around it there. So you shouldn't be going to your kitchen to get water or here because that will just distract you. Because kitchen se idhar aane tak, there is a TV, there is a dining table, there are 3 other people living there who are trying to talk to you.
There's more food in the kitchen.
Yeah, exactly. And keep the place isolated where you work, aisa, ki away from all the distractions, not just
as much as
TV,
possible.
Phone, and here, just people and stuff. And just talk to people ki is time to this time disturb mat karo and then I'm working or something.
You should do that.
And all this will only work if you want to do the work. If you don't want to do it, none of this is gonna work anything. So
first you have to make up your
find mind. Something that you like doing because none of us like doing assignments and we don't have to do them anymore. So maybe you can use a lot of this time isa. Kafi acche se. I mean, you could be whatever you want iske baad, you know that, right? Like, I could be... There are... I mean... What? Sorry. that came out thoda wrong, aisa. You could be whatever you want, aisa. You could learn any skill you want, abhi, aisa. I mean, our college is giving out aisa Coursera ka any course. I mean, a lot of course. Most of the courses, aisa.
You know what happened? So, I got the Coursera link, okay? It was just honestly Coursera kar raha, okay? So I was like, okay, so I signed up for like 7 courses at once, okay? Because I'm
I don't argue with that.
Because I'm extra that way, okay? Jo mereko pasand hai, sign up kar liya. And then, a mail comes later on. saying ki, every student should sign up for a maximum of 3 courses because there is a limit, institutional level limit hai ki tum log kitna courses kar sakte. So if because of me someone else doesn't get courses, I'm sorry guys. Nahin, per person ka 3 wo log na unofficial limit rakha hai. Officially institute level pe kuch limit hai, but then again most of the people are not gonna sign up for it.
They told us ki 3 ये ऐसे उन्होंने एक सेट दिया था ऑफ 6 courses, 5 courses एंड 1 specialization एंड दे सेड दैट इनमें से 3 कोई भी करना कंपलसरी है एंड दैट तुम्हें बाद में चिंता करना है करो.
व्हाट दे गिव यू इज रिलेवेंट टू योर एजुकेशनल स्ट्रीम. इफ यू वांट टू डू समथिंग आउटसाइड ऑफ इट यू विल हैव टू डू इट ऑन योर सेपरेटली.
बट मेरा तो वही है ना, आई वांट टू डू सीएस एनीवे. सो आई नो पीपल हु आर डूइंग बिजनेस हियर.
हां हां नाइस.
सो दैट्स नाइस. Also, that a friend of mine is in my team, Asa, and he's doing all that business wala. So I'm really glad, Asa. Okay? But he is like, meko coding mein kam interest wagera. So yeah, I mean, come on, coding is not Asa ki end game. So you could be any, you could follow any stream you want, Asa. This is kafi early.
That's right.
To judge ki kya kar.
So we are in no way encouraging you to be productive. We just being like, if you want to be productive, this is how to maximum fit. This is not a race. The lockdown is not a race to be productive. It's a lockdown. Okay, you have to.
Survival is your main race for lockdown.
Yeah, that's exactly.
Is,
if you want to.
Is that जिसको चाहिए उसके लिए है.
जिसको चाहिए उसके लिए. If you want to watch Netflix all day, if you want to watch Netflix, watch Dark.
If you want to watch YouTube, watch the Unengineered podcast. We have a lot of episodes.
Oh my god.
Oh. So I'll tell you a story after this ends. It's an amazing story, sir. I don't know if I'm allowed to share it. Maybe baad mein. Maybe we'll share it, sir. Once I get
that was a great
the person.
What do you call it?
Ending. I don't know.
Can we make an outro?
Yeah, let's make an outro. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. You guys are amazing. If you stayed all this time, and
heck yeah.
Yeah, and just tell us what you did like, what you didn't like, and.
Because we're amateurs, we're gonna make this.
Yeah, come on. This is the first time I'm doing it, and it's the second time. So, yeah. I guess that's it.
That's it for today.
Pretty much wraps it up. Chalo. Bye bye.
You can also tell us topics to talk about.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So I'm gonna ask a couple of my friends for topics. Like, unko kya chahiye basically.
Same.
So two hours to this, and yeah. There are a lot of fun topics in tech, but if you want us to talk about something else, we can do that too. We can talk about anything. We're just two guys in a room, in two rooms.
We're not in the same room, guys.
Yeah, come on.
Okay, bye. That's the podcast.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Take care.